Alright, so the head part we require us to load some other reference. So we will going here and in the image we will load a reference and choosing this to be our reference in the front view. And we don't want the empty now, so we will select this reference and going to select here and we also will hide the body for a moment and we will save to B05. Let's increment. So we are in lesson 5 and let's load another reference from here. We will add Shift A, add a reference image to be reference, and we'll select this to be in the right view. So we will rotate 90 degrees in this axis and move in the X axis. And also we will look both, so we have this to be the right view. And we have this to be front view, and both of these will be locked such as this. And after that, all right, so I have loaded the head reference in our in Alwatrib to see what number of edges that we want. So using the brush, we will want. We need an first edge here and second edge here and third edge here. We need four. We need a five here. So these are six edges that we want. And also we need an edge here and we need edge here. And so horizontally we need an edge here, an edge here, and maybe two edges here. And we need maybe one edge here. So let's calculate the number of edges we need. Horizontally or vertically, we need 2 and 12, we need 14. And this, vertically, we need around maybe 14 in this direction. And horizontally, we will need 2, and this will be 3. And 3, 6. So let's say that we need horizontally to be 8 edges and vertically to be 14. All right, so we will start from a circle and this circle. All right, let's start also to match our reference by making an plane, and we will scale this plane and moving in the Z. And also in this x-axis, we will go here. Right. So we will start to select the side view. And I think now we are done. I will lock the axis here, and we don't want our plane anymore. So we will start from a UV sphere, and this UV sphere will have horizontally will be 8 and 14. And 14 multiplied by 2 and the rings will be 8. So let's start to scale our reference. And scale in the x-axis. And also we want to scale here. Alright, so let's move it in place. And scale down. And let's scale this part also. And we will scale it to be here. And again scale down. And we will match this reference, and let's move here. Let's select the vertex and move in this area and scale down here. So we have the general shape. We should scale in one direction, so that was a mistake. So let's scale in x-axis by selecting any or all of these and scale here and going in the top view and scale. Alright, so this is the general shape of the head. Let's see what we have. So I will make this opening here. And one way of making this is to add a loop cut here, and loop cut here, and another loop cut which is here, and loop cut here. And then we can choose this vertex. Alright, anyway, I will duplicate this vertex or this mesh. And move inside the place, and we can select both vertex and move to the design. We will name it to be referenced because we will using a modifier later. So let's see what we have, and this will be the head maybe. And again, in the head we will move in the x-axis. And we can straighten this. So I will delete this vertex for now. And we need also three loops here. So let's add a loop cut here and scale in the x axis to match this reference. And again, we need a loop cut here. And finally, two loop cuts here. So let's move and add two loop cuts here. So to explain that this isn't the only way for making opening, we can leave opening for later. I think that if we leave the opening to the later video, it will be much, much better. But let's continue what we have make. Then we can select all of these faces and we will make a benefit of the mirror modifier. So what we should make is to select all of these vertex and delete, then apply the mirror modifier. So we have we should select all of these faces and shift D on Y. And of course, we don't need these faces anymore. Let's see what we have. Alright, so we have this part. So how we can achieve this part? So now we should start making the head, and I will select this edge and move in the z-axis and scale in the x-axis to be here, and make sure you have activated the clipping so we can scale in the x-axis. And as I have said, we will need an edge here and we will need another edge here. Alright, and we need an edge here, and let's scale it to be at this location, and also we will scale it sometimes like this, and also we can scale. And I will select all the vertex and Alt M to merge at distance to see if we have some duplication, and let's match our reference. So basically we have some extra vertex and we have here some trouble, but no issue. We will select all of these and extrude in Z and delete. Alright, so what if we select all of this vertex and we should. Alright, let's continue. We have all of these. Alright, and I will select some parts here. And move here. Move here and alright. I will select all of these faces and extrude one time in the y-axis up to this area. And again, we will work on this part which is here. We can add in a new mesh. But the most important thing that we want an a place for the ear. So we will select all of these faces. And let's scale down in the x-axis and what I want to make is to connect. I will select three edges from here and three edges from here and make a bridge edge loop. And also, so we have three edges and three edges and we should bridge edge loop like this. Thank you. So let's try to add the subdivision surface, and I think this part we will fix later, and also this part we will fix also, and I think now we are done around 50% of the head, and let's continue in the next lesson.